This is our refinery. For the first time, as a Kurd, we started to dealing with the oil sector. Before that, the Iraqi government, Baghdad, didn't allow the Kurd to deal with the sector. Depending on our constitution, the new constitution of the Iraq, it allowed the regions to deal. But of course, the income of the all the oil is go to the Baghdad, not directly is coming to our region. So many problems it happened between Baghdad and Erbil about how we develop our this sector. So this refinery about 40,000 barrel in day. It's working now, and also we detect the new and discovered a huge field of the natural gas, which are now we are signed an agreement with the Turkey to be part with the Novaco pipelines from the Azerbaijan, Turkmen, and also from the Kurdistan to be linked to that to Europe. So we are not wait that Baghdad to be developed or to the security to provide it at that time. Also, we will go to start with the oil. The constitution allow us, and we started, and no, we are not waiting. We succeed with the oil sector. There are many companies, American, from the Norwegian, from the Turkish, they are working in the sector oil now in our region. Of course, the housing is also one of the main problems on also should have a shortage about that, we started and we allocated the money supporting the private sector for the housing and also the electricity. Before 2004, there was no power plant in the Kurdistan to provide the electricity. We started with through the investing. Now we have in Erbil only about 500 megawatt, which is running by the fuel is gas turbine. We implement and we succeed. So you can imagine how is the difference between Baghdad and Kurdistan about people, how daily have they have electricity. 2 months ago, the Ministry of the Finance in the Baghdad, the federal Minister of the Finance, they announced they spent about $27 billion on the electricity. $24 billion from the Iraqi fund and $3 billion from the American fund. But they didn't add any megawatt to the Iraqi production of the power plants. So now the people in the Baghdad, they have about 2 to 4 hours, not more. In Kurdistan, the people now, they have 21 hours electricity. That means the power plant, the transmission line, the substation has been implemented, and the three provinces have been connected through the high transmission line. So we succeed with the electricity. So the situation of the electricity is very different between the region and also the other part. Unfortunately, in the Baghdad, they didn't do anything for the electricity till now. At the same time, they spend a very huge budget for the electricity, and we don't know what they make with the money. And also for the education and the higher education now, we have Shwefat, it is a Lebanian international school. We have Ishik from the Turkey, also international school. Behind that, schools and our system of the education, we changed the system. And also for the higher education, we have a large number of the private university. We have American University in Sulaymaniyah. We have the British University in Erbil, Jihan University, Kurdistan University. They are all of private university. It is working very well, and the people are coming not only for the Kurdistan, from Baghdad, the students are coming to work to be in these universities. So the situation of the education is changing really. And also with the health sector, the same thing that happened now is Erbil is the center for the whole Iraq. Many famous Iraqi doctors, especially the Sunni Arab from Baghdad, instead they go to the Amman or to the Emirate, now they came to the Erbil. We have done more than 900 of them. They have their private hospitals, and also they employed in the Ministry of the Health and also in the Ministry of the Higher Education to be the teacher. So the patients from the different cities, from the Iraq, Baghdad, from the south, from the middle, from the Mosul, Anbar, they came to the Erbil for the treatment, because now the growth of the health sector is developed. It's a big center for the whole Iraq. And of course, for the roads, for the traffic, we started with the projects. For the environment, there are new very parks. We changed many big parts for the city to be a big parts like this one, which called Shanadar, and this is the place of the Iraqi Fifth Army of the Saddam, which called Maskar Wuk, Faylaq al-Khamis.
Yeah, it was the camp
of the Iraqi. We built a big park in the same place. For the agriculture, now we have our strategy plan for the 5 years. That's mean because we have Arbil allocated between the two rivers, the upper river and also the lower river, and which we connected to the Tigris river. But we haven't any dam and irrigation system, so we have a strategic plan how to build the dams and to make our irrigation system that, because our farmers, they are depending on the rain, and the drought has been effect on the our production and our capability of the farmers. So we have a good plan for the strategic plan, and we started with the small dams to build to support also this sector. And also for the local administration, for the district, sub-district, and also the women, now they involved with the government, with the police. When the students, when they came to the Kurdistan in the airport, they find the women in the airport for the they are functioning very well and they are very active. And this is some part of the middle projects. And our former prime minister, after all this is, he believed that the private sector should participate with the public to develop and our region. So we succeed, and now we have a good change and growth in the capability of the private sector, like Mr. Badreddin as a businessman. They are working and they are doing very well. So for the investing, now we have around, this is the sector which will be housing, tourism, heavy and light industrial. This is the sectors which we, for the investment, is it covered. So now we have around $8 billion from the investing. We spend around $4 billion as a government and $8 billion as a private sector and investor. Unfortunately, mostly it's from local. And this is mean how our policy succeed and give the capability for our people to be growth and to invest and to be succeed. And also we have an international investing about 1.4, and also shared investing between the local and the international, and they are doing very well. And this is the sector of the every sector for the investing, which is block shown. This is the biggest one, which is about $1 billion. There are another towers, another additional buildings for the in the center of the city. And also we have different malls and industrial. This is the name of the projects.